wish I could remember all their names. My 20,000 ghosts, they all have names. Beautiful African names. We call them with just grunts, noises. We were apes. They were human.
Was blind, but now I see.
When one thinks about the life of William Wilberforce, when one thinks about the life of John Newton, and how those lives intersected and ultimately helped change the course of world history, I like to think of that as the true story behind the hymn Amazing Grace. Newton was writing about himself, the grace that saved a wretch like me. And we know Newton's story. He was a former slave ship captain himself, someone who had reached the very depths of human depravity. By his own account, he always referred to himself as the great African blasphemer. He had himself been enslaved when he was in Africa. He had reached the lowest point in his life. He was rescued out of that set of circumstances by an amazing providence. Somehow, long years after he'd been a slave ship captain, he was able to become a clergyman, a hope that his own mother had harbored for him years and years before. She died sadly when Newton was a boy, but she'd always hoped he'd become a clergyman. He came full circle. And so that redemptive theme, woven into the tapestry of Newton's life, but also into the tapestry of history. Think about it for just a second. Here is John Newton, a man guilty of crimes against humanity. It was Newton who was the instrument God raised up to place a protege, William Wilberforce, on the path of service to humanity. And together, they worked to end the slave trade. Newton lived long enough to see it. And then after Newton died in 1807, Wilberforce himself lived long enough to see, just 3 days before he died, that slavery itself was going to end. It's one of the most remarkable chapters we have in modern history. It's an amazing thing. If you were to sit down and to write a great dramatic script, I don't think you could invent anything more dramatic or powerful than the notion that it started way back with Newton. His coming to faith. His renouncing the life he'd once served.
I once was blind, but now I see. Didn't I write that too?
Yes, you did.
Well, now at last it's true.
Amazing.